I wanted to start today just very quietly. We've all been kind of keeping some space for a lot of things going on in the world right now. And so I want to start just by focusing on breathing. So with me, please take a nice deep breath in and exhale. Breathe in. And exhale. Breathe in. And exhale. And let's start with our warm-ups today of our body, getting ourselves moving. I'm going to begin with some isolations. And we're going to move through all of those as we get ourselves doing our edge class. So starting with just our head.
That if you talk in our sense, then you'll lose your mind.
Center.
Right in front of me,
bring your shoulders up,
some sense to
head down.
And I found love where it wasn't supposed to
down.
Be. Right in front of me,
down. Circle the floor,
some sense to me. And I'll use you as a makeshift game. How much to give and how much to take. I'll use you as a warning sign. That if you talk enough sense, then you'll lose your mind. And I found love where it wasn't supposed to be.
Your arms
right in front of me. It's home, some sense to me. And I found love where it wasn't supposed to be.
Back
right in front of me. It's home, some sense to me.
Think of your rib cage, we're going to slide it side, side, center, side, center, side, center, side, center, front. Center, back, center, front, center, back, center, make a circle to the right, back, side, and front,
right, back, where it wasn't supposed to be.
Reverse.
Left in front of me,
strength,
sense to me.
Right.
And I found love where it wasn't
So, moving from here into our hips, I want you to think of going right, center, left, center, right, center, left, center, and tipping front, center, and back, center, front, center, back, center, make a circle to the right, going right, back, left, front, right, back, left, front, a little quicker, round. Switch. Left, back, right, front, left, back, right, and front, smooth circle, round, and round. Moving into our leg, roll your ankle knee and hip in more. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, reverse, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, switch legs, rolling in one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, rolling out, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Into your feet, roll up to your toe with the right. Back to your toe. Heel down. Toe. Stretch over. Back to your toe. Heel down. Toe, over, back to toe, toe, down, toe, back to toe, down, switch feet, toe, position. I'm going to take a second to take the screen down so that you can see my feet better. Okay, so starting with our plies in a parallel position, we're going to think about our Arms coming up as we bend, really stretching through the body, keeping everything long and lifted. Two to the front, one to the right, one to the left, and then we're going to return two to the front. Same thing in first position, two to the front, right, left, two front, right, left. And then we're going to do the same thing in second. So a nice wide second position, really thinking about keeping your hips under you as you bend. So let's begin. Up. Through. To right. Turning the foot out, extending back, lifting, pulling up long and tall through both legs before rebending to do the next side. I'm just going to keep that piece of music rolling.
If you ever noticed, I've been ashamed all my life. I've been playing games.
Okay. Switch your ways.
We can try to hide it. It's all the same. I've been losing one day at a time. Bleeding, I'm bleeding.
Step back.
My cold little arm. Oh, I can't stand myself. And I can
find
my heart. And this cold heart. I can live.
Okay, let's move into our side lunges. So beginning with our vanilla position, we think of our plie. We're going to push the right arm through and extend to the right foot. Come through. Reverse on the other side, left arm, left foot, through, arms coming overhead, and through, arm up on the other side, and then reaching down, and through, down, and through. Let's go back to that.
warning sign. And if you're talking off sense, then you'll lose your mind.
From here, let's think about our crossovers. So starting with our left outside edge, we would think about pushing into our stroke, getting that understroke position through. We're going to step onto an inside edge, lift up and open into that arabesque, focusing on that nice line, rebend, pushing onto our right, crossing through with the left, and then stepping on that right inside and opening it up on each. Thinking about those outside edges each time on those pliés, I want you to really think of hitting that nice diagonal line, turning out your foot, pliéing both knees as you cross through, and then readjusting into your next crossstroke. Here we go. Outside, hold, PA, and under, hold, PA, under, cross through, turn out, stretch, PA, under, through, turn out, hold, PA, under, Hold, yay, and right, Please straighten my mirror. Literally everything in this place is not level, so it's the mirror is actually the one level thing. Okay, so moving on from here, I want to really think about some of our backwards movement. We've focused less on this, so we're going to do similar to our crossover inside. We're going to think of a backwards crossover. And then we're gonna step wide to the inside edge and then shift the weight of the hips over to start the next one. So thinking about those nice long stroke positions, thinking about lifting up in your body as you go. Okay, last thing to this music for right now. Five, six, seven, I'm starting on the right, step right, cross left, inside, shift left, cross right, extend, inside, hold, shift to the right, cross left, inside, and then hold, switch to the left, cross right, inside, edge, and hold. Okay. Wonderful. Okay, so moving on from here, let's get right into John Curry's Mohawk exercise. So brief reminder, we're gonna do it with the arms plain first. I want you to think of stepping on the right, bringing the heel of your left foot to the arch of your right foot as we Mohawk and extend. And then plie and coupe that foot in before we step forward onto the right. And we switch sides left, bringing the right foot in at the arch with the heel to do your Mohawk on that side. Plie, coupe, and step forward on the left inside. So alternating back and forth, keep things really neat. Work on that carriage of position the whole way through the exercise. There's so many beautiful moments in this pattern. I want you to find all of them. So. Right. Mohawk left. Coupe. Step forward. Left. Mohawk to right. Coupe, step forward. Right, Mohawk left. Coupe, step forward. Left, Mohawk right. Coupe, step forward. Let's repeat it, adding the arm. So as your foot comes in, that arm is going to follow, lift up, and then step through. All right. Right, left, big step forward, left, right, big step forward, right, left, big step forward, left, right. Once again, reading on or leaning on John's phenomenal background in a veg class, let's do some bower threes. So I want you to be thinking about really stepping strong on that side, using your leg to pivot yourself up and over your turn on the ball of your foot. You should have two straight knees at the apex of the turn. So we're just going to start plain arms, step on the left, extending back. Standing up and over your turn, hit that nice check line, coupe, and then we're going to step and repeat on the right, turn and check. Okay. Each time really thinking about that nice, tall, proud alignment over your feet. Okay. Six, seven, eight, step left, extend, turn, extend, face, step right, extend, turn, face, left, extend, turn, face, right, extend, turn, okay, let's repeat it one more time with arms. So as we go, left arm, turn, right arm. Ready, 5, 6, 7, 8, down you go, turn, hold us back, right, feel free, turn along, okay, left, turn, right, hold, turn, okay, not too bad, you guys. Moving on from here, let's work into our inside threes. So as a reminder of the pattern we usually do, I'll be stepping on my right foot, keeping the extension the whole way through the turn. I'm gonna stand up on my standing leg, keep that behind me. Step forward on my left, cross through with my right, and then repeat on the left. So left extension, return and stay. Stepping forward on the right, crossing through with the left, alternate. Again, no arms the first time through, and then on the second time we do the pattern, we'll add the beautiful overhead arm on the chair. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, so I want to get into, I've held back on our arabesques for a little bit longer today because I wanted to combine them with some spirals and have you guys a little bit more warmed up than we usually are when we do them. So we're gonna do our arabesque circles as usual. I'm gonna start on the left with my left arm in front like I'm doing an outside edge. We'll do a quarter turn each direction. This will all be the same, but when we get to the end, instead of doing a little lift up, I actually want you to think of we're going to bring the arm in and we're gonna spiral over on that very last one. So giving a little extra challenge today, you're gonna switch the arm position. You're gonna work on, after you've just had the challenge of holding that leg up, we're gonna lean it over. So a little bit more difficult today, but I think you guys are up to the challenge. So I'm going to just go ahead and let this repeat itself. This is much easier. There we go. So starting on our left foot, we're going to extend back, lift, hold. Hold. Quarter turn towards your left shoulder. Stay. Take a moment to check in with your extensions before we turn to the back. And quarter turn. Extend, really make sure you're reaching. Turn back to the front. Bring your arms up. Spiral over. Come down. Bring your feet in. Give yourself a second to plie before we reset. To the right. So we're going to extend back with left, up, hold, hold, quarter turn to your right shoulder, stay, easy reach, turn to the back, reach long, feel like that energy is coming out of all of the body parts, quarter turn to the right, watch the position of your foot, back to the front, stay, lift up, spiral over, come down, breathing in, that was exciting, I just keep moving along. Let's go the other direction, so like our inside edges. So this time standing on the left, rotating towards the right. So my right arm is gonna be in front here. I'm gonna turn my foot, extend back, and hold. Really reaching these positions. Quarter turn towards the right. Quarter turn to the back. Pick a point to focus on. Quarter turn towards your shoulder. Quarter turn to the front. Lift up. Spiral over. Down, close, give yourself a little plie, and let's reset. So now turning towards your left shoulder, standing on your right foot. Prepare, move my left arm in front, extend and lift, hold, turn towards your left shoulder. Really feel like you're lifting out of your position. Or return to the back. Strong. Pull up out of that standing leg. Or return towards your left. Quarter turn to the front. Bring the arms up. Spiral over. Come down. Plie. Shake your legs out for a second. I know a lot of people get kind of tense on this one, trying to hold it. And I wanted to give you one more similar challenge today to this pattern. So we've worked this in arabesque, but we have never worked it with our foot in front of us. And so I'm going to try that today. So just to kind of explain the turn, because we're thinking of it as more akin to a back three turn than a front one, your weight will be turning over the heel of your foot as we check this position. And we want to think of that free leg in front of us lined up in front of our standing foot, just like if we were holding this on a back outside edge after cross stroke. So really be a little more cushioned over these turns for yourself. Use that free leg to help you check your positions. We would be thinking about facing very open over our circle. So I'm going to have you begin in a parallel today, extending your foot forward. So it will be the opposite arm as leg. We're gonna do the same thing where we quarter turn each side. I personally like to remain relatively square as I do this, but I want to, since it's our first time, mostly establish, like, find your balance here, turning over that heel of your foot a little bit. Okay, so last time throw on this music. Six. Standing on the right, turning towards the left, extend forward and lift, extend, really feel that turn out through your hip, quarter turn towards your left, hold, feel like you're standing tall and long through your body, quarter turn to the back, hold, quarter turn to the side. Quarter turn to the front. And place down. Let's switch feet. So now standing on the left, turning towards the right. I'm going to extend my right foot forward. Lift it up. And stay. Quarter turn towards the right. Again, feeling that heel of your foot in the ground as you turn on the ball of your foot. Quarter turn to the back. Stay. Stay. Quarter turn to the right. Turn back to the front. Hold. And finish. Fantastic. So in working with some of these ideas, I want to now do a few more turn-based patterns that move a little bit more. So we're going to do our Waltz 3 pattern that we've been doing, where we think of taking that return just like our Bower 3. We're going to push back into a landing position on the opposite foot. Step forward on the initial foot. So in this case, it would be left, then right, then left. Round down, roll up, and then we're going to repeat it on the right. So right foot, turn, push back onto that landing position on the left. Step forward on the right. Up and down, roll up and open. And every time we roll up and open, I want you guys to really feel like you're loosening your chest. You're really taking up space in your body because it just feels so good. We all need that.
I can't believe I can't let it go.
Okay. Step left. Turn. Landing position. Step forward. Down. Up. Right.
I can't believe I
turn. Push into your landing position. Step forward. Outside Mohawks, we've done this the last couple weeks, so I want to think about stepping on my left foot. I'm going to be bringing my right heel behind me, stepping onto the right, hooping this foot back in, and stepping forward on the left. And then repeating the other side, so I'm stepping on the right, and bringing my foot behind me onto the left, hooping in, and stepping forward. All right. Can I explain again on what I mean, turning on my heel? Yes, when I was talking earlier about turning on the heel, when we think about a forward three turn, we think about lifting up and over the ball of our foot. When we think about a back three turn, we want the ball of the foot to lift over the heel. So you're thinking about picking up your toes. Sorry, I didn't catch that earlier. Okay, so let's do our outside Mohawks. And switch up my music today for this one. Good. 5, 6, 7, 8. Step left.
And right. Cushion every bit of
step forward.
Salt to take some food.
Together.
Right.
Extend.
Away from winter, the warm of the day
flows. Extend.
Away from winter, the bottom of the day flows.
Left. Pattern today, and this is one we have not done yet in this class, but it's very simple. And we're going to do it once slow, and then we're going to add a variation to it that's a little bit more lighthearted and fun. And I'm going to tip my screen down on Zoom so that I have a little bit more space where you can see my feet. So I want to be thinking about starting on my right foot. And for those of you who have been have done a program where you've had a Mohawk cross in it, I'm going to be thinking of Mohawk cross, Mohawk cross. But we're going to do it very slowly. So each time I'm bringing my foot through for that Mohawk, I'm stepping on my right. I'm extending my left leg. I'm going to be plieing as I bring my left leg behind me, crossing over on the right, and then I'm going to come from a coupe here, step onto the left, get my extension, bring my foot behind me, cross right, da, da, da. And we're going to be holding longer on the cross than we are on the Mohawk part. There's a reason for that that you will figure out as we go along. So let's do that.
Cazuela, capítulo 7. Minas, de cerca, cada vez más de cerca. Entonces jugamos al sol.
So giving myself a little bit of a head when I'm talking on Zoom. I'm going to think about that same Mohawk. I'm not going to worry as much about keeping the extension long here. I'm going to worry a lot more about keeping a slight plie and keeping my feet underneath me. So I'm thinking of Mohawk cross, and then I'm going to do tap, tap. Mohawk cross, tap, tap. Mohawk cross, tap, tap. Mohawk cross, tap, tap. So it's going to go a little quicker. We want to think of, again, just keep everything underneath you, keep a slight little bounce to it, and really kind of, you know, I'm trying to not slam my foot down on the floor because downstairs neighbors, but, you know, if you have all the space in the world and you want to, like, really get into it, get into it. And we're going to try to make it a little bit more lively and fun. So if I'm thinking about my body position, I'm going to add a little shoulders to this. Step, step, across, step, step. So if you feel comfortable doing that, you're at home, you're in your safe spaces, please go for it. It's fun. If you don't and you want to just add the step, step, make it however feels right for you. But let's try that pattern now with the increased speed. Something a little more entertaining than usual today. All right, so we've made it through all of those things. I'm going to do some spirals, and then we're going to do the river pattern with you guys. So, because it wouldn't be my class if I didn't end on river. So let's start on our right leg, thinking about extending into these spirals. We've just done some quick movements. Let's take a nice long one. I want you to extend your left foot back for me. Lift your arms up. Really feel like you're creating space in your middle. Get into that arabesque and spiral over. We're gonna stay here for a second. And then we're gonna try to pulse up with that leg. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Back to your plane spiral. And come down. Let's do the other side, same thing. So I'm going to be bringing my arms up, creating that space in my body, extending my right leg back, lifting up and over into my spiral. And I'm gonna stay here and pulse up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hold the spiral again. And come down and through. Okay, it's river time. For those of you who already know the pattern, you know that we start on 2 feet. We're gonna step out with the right, with the arms extended for our count 1. Down on 2, if you can make it the whole way down here, great. If not, just pull in low. Extend like our side lunge on 3, feet together on 4. Then we repeat to the other side, so stepping out on the left, curling in, extending the left side through, and together. Make it really big and punchy. It's fun that way. All right, so here we go. Skating community to bring us together. We're happy to have this space and time to remember our movements and come together as a group. I would love to encourage you to join us on Thursday for our choreo lab at 1:30 featuring Liz Schmidt. She's amazing. She's performed with Ice Theater. She was the original skater and has skated with our gala several times for Lorna Brown's piece When Atoms Embrace. She's lovely. I'm very excited for her class. And as always, we appreciate you being here. We appreciate your donations to support our work. And take care of yourselves and each other right now. I think that's really important for all of us to remember. So thank you all so much. And you are now allowed to unmute yourselves if you would like.
Thank you, Sarah.
Thank you. Thank you, Sarah.
Thank you.
Thank you. Great seeing you. Be safe.
You too.
Thank you.
Bye.
Hi, everyone. Hi, Moira.
Yeah, bye.